Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and this is chapter 83, Whatever I Take, Takes My First Two Months. Let's get started. As a kid, doing the right thing seemed so simple. Don't lie, be nice, play by the rules. But as an adult, he realized the people who make the rules are often the ones breaking them the most. And sometimes, to do the right thing, you have to be ready to buck the system and let the cards fall where they may. At lunch, on the day of the heist, Mac and I met Ava at her locker. Adrenaline shooting through our veins. Who's ready to show some chaos? Not so loud. If we want this to work, we can't give Jennings a reason to come early. Relax. He had sent Applegate first, and as much as I love the old gal, something tells me we would take her. With a toss of her ear, Ava reached into her locker and plunked down two big cooler jugs of water and a full box of empty balloons. Whoa, someone came prepared. Did he rob a thirsty clown? How had you sneak all that past security? That's between me and Bozo. Or, you know, the bargain bin at this party store. I fought back a snort, and Ava shot me a silent that sent the butterflies in my stomach into overdrive. We turned our backs outward, blocking the view as best we could as we filled the water balloons and divided them between us. When we get the signal, we make sure all hell breaks loose. And don't forget, once Jennings gets here, we cannot let him leave. The boys need as much time as we can give them to get whatever's in that safe. Mac and Ava both nodded, and I looked up to see Mason and Nor walk past us together, nodding discreetly as they headed towards the office. Game time. Lock and load, ladies. We dug into the cafeteria, and my fingers tightened around my first water balloon, my hands suddenly shaking with nerves. Hey. Ava covered my hand with hers, and as I met her eyes, my worries melted away. I'm right here. No matter what, we are in this together. She squeezed my hand, and with my hat in my throat, I leapt up onto the nearest table, water balloon in hand. Alright, Addy, first strike. Make it count. I should hit. Lauren. Chant. Hey, Lauren. Incoming. I launched the balloon square at her chest, and the entire cafeteria erupted in laughter at her squeal. What is the actual hell, Adi? What a fight! Mac and Ava offered their stashes to the masses, and teams quickly formed. Photographic club, huddle up. Hey, for once, lunch isn't lame. Take this. Best senior prank ever. All around us, the entire lunchroom broke out in water balloon dodgeball, sending flurries of color whizzing by on all sides. I am going to use the tables as cover. Launch a sneak attack. Tony, I'll distract them. You go around the side and hit them where they won't expect it. Roger that. I made myself a target, taking a couple water balloon hits. But the wet feeling in my socks was worth it the second Tony and the other girls unloaded on the football team. Students poured into the courtyard as the fighting intensified, and Ava and I slipped out behind them. Water balloons froze in the snow and laughter floated up into the air. Max skidded to a halt next to us, grinning. Cue Jennings in 3, 2, everyone stop throwing balloons this instant. Principal Jennings had finally showed, and he was pissed. For a moment, the whole school stood still, water balloons frozen in hand. Not today. A thrill rushed through me as I launched another water balloon straight at him. The balloon exploded on impact, and all around us, the seniors laid out a defiant roar. Hell yeah, you can't stop us. Balloons flew again, this time with gusto, and Principal Jennings glared daggers into me amidst the chaos. Miss Price, I have had just about enough. Now you are coming to my office, now. No, it's not too soon. Why don't we buy the boys some time and give Jennings something to really yell about? Ava held up some empty balloons in one hand and a bottle of maple syrup in the other. Oh, Ava, that's evil. I love it. What had you say? We up the ante a little. I have some additional ammo too. Meg opened her backpack to reveal three cans of paint with vibrant pigments. Ava temptingly waved the bottle of maple syrup. It's time to get some real payback. Let's show Jennings who's the boss. Stick to the water balloons. Show Jennings who's the boss. Bahut great Jennings ka. Ab hamari bari. Break out the goods. Jennings is gonna pay. Yes, I knew you had been into it. What do you want to fill the first balloon with? Soda, paint, syrup, paint. It's not toxic, but it will absolutely join that fancy shirt he's wearing. The messier, the better. Put it in here. I held the balloon until it was full. It was so full, it looked ready to burst. Principal Jennings closed in on us. Use the bench to get a good shot. We'll cover you. Ava grabbed a stray backpack, using it as a shield to guard me from incoming balloons as I climbed onto the bench. Get down from there this instant. Hey Jennings, dodge this. This one's for Mason. The balloon struck Jennings straight in the chest and he recoiled in disgust. Gah, what is this? Paint coated his clothes in an explosive pattern, dyeing his outfit with acrylic. How dare you? Do you have any idea how much professional wear costs? Don't worry, I hear you can afford more just fine. Principal Jennings ducked and weaved through the students, aiming right for me, Ava and Mackenzie. Good job, we got his attention. What now? The longer we keep him busy, the longer he isn't getting back to the office. Then it's time for a good, old-fashioned goose chase. Let's split up. I lazed my fingers through Ava's and we dashed to the school greenhouse as Mac ran the other direction. We stomped at the base of the tree at the room's center and as I tipped my head back to look up, Ava grinned. Think you can come out of the retirement for one last cheerleading stunt? Or have you lost your touch? I couldn't help but grin as I gripped her shoulders and locked eyes with her, my foot sliding into her open hands. Never lost it, but I could use a spotter. You know, I'd always catch you if you fall. She lifted me into the branches and I offered her a boost up just as Principal Jennings stormed through the door. Get down from here. Loosen up, Principal Jennings. It's just a prank. Speaking of, I held out another nasty water balloon and Jennings backed away. You wanna do the honors? I say we share it. Together, we threw the balloons and Jennings let out a startled groan as a nasty mix of soda, paint and syrup splattered every inch of his clothes. The battle had spread out into the hallways with more students joining every second. At Jennings' scream, some trickled into the greenhouse. Oh, that's rank, man. I'm so taking a video of this. Principal Jennings scowled and vibrated with anger. This is insanity. Mrs. Applegate, go for reinforcements. As Principal Jennings stormed out and started enlisting the teachers, Ava and I climbed back down. We were sitting ducks. My stomach churned as the war continued. Dread started seeping in as I realized just how much trouble we would be in. Ava bumped my shoulder with her own and shot me a soothing smile. Hey, it's gonna be okay. How can you be so sure? Because you have a way of making even the worst problems feel like they'll be gone in minutes. If anyone can find our way through, it's you. Ava, that's how you make me feel. Feel free to keep saying nice things about me. No matter what happens, you always keep so cool. You're the first person to start fighting out how to mix things. I admire that about you. My pulse jumped at the way her eyes lit up. I learned from the best. You bonded with Ava during the prank. I like where this is going, but we should get out of here. And I think I know just the way to do it. I sucked in a deep breath and called out to the warning seniors. Attack the teachers! All around me, students answered the call. And balloons flew, splashing the cavalry as it arrived, giving us just enough cover to sneak back at the hallway. But not without taking a few hits of our own. Oh my god, Addy, you are soaked. I'm soaked. Look at you. And I did, taking in the way the drenched fabric clung to her every curve. but it was the look she gave me back that made my heart lurch. Addie, I should kiss her, hand her my last water balloon. My arms circled Ava's shoulder and her hands wound around my waist. Amidst the chaos, my lips found hers and the commotion melted away. When I pulled back, the smile on her face was radiant and my breath caught in my throat. Ava, until a water balloon flew over our safe haven and hit our heads, soaking us both. To be continued? Definitely. But as the last water balloon soared through the air, Principal Jennings stormed toward us with Mrs. Applegate and a crowd of teachers in tow. This ends now. Round them up. Out of breath, Mac rounded the corner and jerked to a stop next to us. Did we do it? Did we buy Masson and Gnaw enough time? It hasn't been long enough. We planned for them to have at least 5 more minutes. So we are gonna get in all this trouble and they're toast anyway. Not if I can help. I bolted up, dodging around the crowd of students, and ran straight for the fire alarm. Hey Jennings, let's see how you handle this. The noise blared through the campus and one by one, classroom doors opened into chaos as the rest of the students' body tried to evacuate. Mac, Ava and I turned to run, but behind us, a gaggle of teachers formed a wall to block our path. And as Jennings talked toward us filled with fury, I just hoped that ditch effort would give Masson and Gnaw the time they needed. Hey guys, this was it for chapter and I hope you liked it. Bye bye. Thank you for watching me till end.